once you've developed trust, or you see that trust is gaining deeper roots, you start now encouraging the change in their attitude. Because as a consequence of trust that's building up, you will see people who were skeptical, you know, becoming more positive. You will see people who had doubts, people who were cynical, people who were resisting, you know, lower the level of their resistance. So you will see a change in their attitude. And a change in their attitude is important, because the way the process usually works at a macro level is you address them on a cognitive level, that's the rational and the logical, that's the mind, and then that moves to the attitude level, and that's their approach, their spirit, the way their soul reacts, their emotional, you know, dimension, the attitude. And then the third is the change of behavior. Here we are at the middle level, where we're seeing, as a result of them being convinced with your argument, as a result of the trust that has been, you know, has been built and is being continuously more and more, you know, compiling, what will happen is that you will see this shift in their attitude. Now, you have to remember that you can't wait for all of them to change their attitude. You can't. Especially if you have a big team. If you have a team of, you know, dozens or hundreds, and in many cases thousands, what are you going to do? You're going to wait until every single person has changed their attitude? You can't do that. So what you do is that you wait until there is a critical mass of a positive change of attitude, enough to start a good momentum, you know, if enough mass, enough people that will start snowballing, a snowballing effect, something that you can, you know, use to embark on your actual journey of changing behavior and going through this, you know, transformation in mentality, in mindset, and in paradigm. So you focus on those, but you keep an eye on the negative ones. It is possible that people who still have negative attitude, they need more time. It is possible that they need more convincing. It is possible that they want you to talk to them in a different way, to change your communication style. It is possible that they have their own reasons. It is possible that some of them will never be convinced, you know, maybe a minority of them. So what you need to do is to monitor all this, you know, this overall mood, and make sure that it is actually moving towards the positive. And you need to use that to build momentum and move forward, because that's your purpose. Your purpose is to do what it takes so that the actual change happen. The actual change in the mindset and the mentality, you know, and the paradigm actually happens.